What's up? So that title is no joke. Last night, this morning, I experienced a miracle 100% to the max, no doubt, and I wanted to share the story with you guys. So last night, in the middle of the night, I wake up with throbbing pains in my tailbone. It's kind of weird. I've never felt anything like this before. It was just in my tailbone, very irritating throbbing pain, and it woke me up. I had a hard time sleeping, and I was afraid to get out of bed. And this morning, sure enough, I wake up, get out of bed, and really bad. Really, it's almost impossible to walk. It was, every step was just shooting pain. Like, on a scale of 1 to 10, I would say probably an 8, to give you an accurate description. If you've ever had a cramp in your legs or calves, you know what it's like, and it's just like crippling, you know. It's, oh, you can't hardly even walk. And that's what I was experiencing. And just sitting up and standing up and sitting down and standing up from a chair was just so almost impossible. And so I, about 30, 45 minutes after I wake up, I notice a perspective change. My mindset had just totally shifted to, this was the most important, the only thing on my mind was to, how can I get rid of this pain? And so I had to go to the bathroom. So I go to the bathroom, sit down on the toilet, and I just start praying to God. I just start praying that He would please take this pain away from me. And unfortunately, I know that there's many of you out there that you hear me say the word God or Jesus or the Bible, and you automatically dismiss everything that I'm going to say. But I encourage you, you out there that cannot get past that terminology, to just stick with me through the story, because this is the real deal. So I'm sitting on the toilet. I know it sounds kind of funny, but this is just how it happened. And I'm praying to God, and I'm reading a little book that I read every morning called Jesus Calling Handbook. And for those of you that know that book, you know the miracle and the power behind that book. And so I'm reading it, and today's message was about putting intimate time with God above all else. You know, it's so easy to get caught up in the world of our desires, our things, our goals, our aspirations, our anxieties, the things that bother us, the things that bring us down. It's so easy to get enveloped into these worldly matters, when God, just what He wants for us is to spend intimate time with Him. And this is a reoccurring theme, a reoccurring message that I've been receiving over the past couple months. And so I'm just on the toilet, just really, just all I can think about is just, God, please take this away from me. I don't know where this even came from. It's so bothersome to me, because, you know, I love being active. I love moving around, flipping around, and paranoia is starting to take over. You know, I'm starting to have paranoid thoughts of like, wow, is this going to be crippling? Is this going to be with me for the rest of my life? Am I going to not be able to do things that I love anymore? And so I'm sitting there, and I'm just praying to God that please take this away from me. And this is going to sound crazy, but I heard His voice, and I heard Him say to me, Nathaniel, get up. You're good. Get up, stand up. And in this moment, I'm really scared for two reasons. One reason, I want Him to be true. I want this to be God speaking to me. You know, I'm afraid that, whoa, is this just you speaking to yourself? I'm afraid I'm gonna be disappointed. And number two, I'm scared to get off the toilet, because it's so freaking painful. It was scary to stand up. Scary to get up from the couch. Scared to get from just stand up and stand down, sit down. It's just so painful. So I get up, and the pain is nowhere to be found. I felt nothing. And immediately I thought to myself, God, if this is true, if you just did this, I'm gonna go out into the woods. I'm gonna walk down to the woods, walk down to that creek, and I'm gonna praise You. I'm gonna give You glory. I'm gonna acknowledge this miracle that just took place. 5 minutes previous to this, I could not even barely walk. I could hardly sit down on the toilet. And And I'm walking around my house not saying a word because I didn't want to get ahead of myself and tell my family that something that wasn't true. So I'm walking, I'm squatting down, I'm doing full squats to the floor, stretching my hamstrings, making sure this is true. And then I just tell my family, I'm like, a miracle just happened to me, absolutely. And I go to the woods, I start praying and giving praise to God, and just start, I'm crying, I'm so just enveloped. I feel like his arms are wrapped around me. And that's my miracle. And it's, and today I went to later on the day, I went to the gym doing flips, handstands, you know, just rolling around. And if you told me that I was going to be at a gym later on today, earlier this morning, I would have thought you were crazy. And that's it, guys. And, you know, I had to share this with you. Those of you who believe, you know where I'm coming from. Those of you who are skeptics and, you know, just think the whole God Bible thing is crazy, I acknowledge you, and my word to you is that I would be doing you a disservice by not expressing and not sharing this experience with you. Don't you agree? How could I hold back something like this? And I've experienced, this is just one of many things that I've experienced in my lifetime that is just so evident of the way God works. That, and I'm tired of holding it back, so I'm ready to give. And I want to praise God. And I feel like he allowed this little physical ailment to happen to me for two reasons. And I believe the one reason was so I could share it with others, so glory can be brought to his name. And I feel by holding that back, I just can't do it. I can't not share this story because God has blessed me, and I want to share his glory. I want to glorify him. And that's one. And number two, and that's just to spend intimate time with him. And when my health was deteriorating, I mean, just this little physical ailment, anytime your health deteriorates, that's what matters. All of your other concerns drop, and it brings you to a place of just helplessness, and you start to pray. And, you know, why wait for those times of desperation? Just go to him and really spend time with him every day. And that's been such a powerful practice in my life that I just can't not share it with you. So, yeah, guys. That's my miracle.